Our next station is the Basilica of Saint Lawrence outside the walls. Rich in history and art, it is a unique place that will implant a sense of peace and imminence. Why is this basilica so significant? After the apostles Peter and Paul, Saint Lawrence is regarded as the most prominent of all the martyrs of Rome. Saint Lawrence was a Roman deacon under Pope Saint Sixtus II. He suffered martyrdom in the year 258 during the persecution of Emperor Valerian. As a deacon, Lawrence was charged with the responsibility for the material goods of the church and the distribution of alms to the poor. When Lawrence knew he would be arrested, he sought out the poor, widows, and the orphans of Rome and gave them all the money he had on hand, selling even the sacred vessels of the altar to increase the sum. According to the traditions, he was roasted to death on a gridiron. The basilica started its existence as a small oratorium built in the 4th century by the Emperor Constantine in Agro Verano on the spot where the saint was buried. Towards the end of the 6th century, Pope Pelagius II had an actual church constructed at this site. In the 13th century, Pope Honorius II had a new one built in front of the existing church. The two churches were later united into one structure, and many other modifications were carried out throughout the following centuries. The church is preceded by a white square commissioned by Pope Pius IX, and what we see here is a column surmounted by the statue of Saint Lawrence. The monastery and the wonderful 13th century Romanesque bell tower are on the other hand next to the church. Besides sarcophagi and marble slabs, the portico houses important frescoes depicting the lives of Saint Lawrence and Saint Stephen. The basilica was seriously damaged during the World War II. On July 19, 1943, a large bomb fell just outside the portico, which was almost destroyed by the blast. Fortunately, the actual church facade with its frescoes remained standing. Also, a smaller bomb pierced the roof and exploded on the floor. The basilica was subsequently repaired, the work being completed in 1949, but the interior fresco work and some of the floor were beyond repair. As we enter inside, we can see that despite the reconstruction, the church maintains its original form, keeping intact the fascination and harmony of its structure. The crypt contains the remains of Saint Lawrence, Saint Stephen, and Saint Justin. The mosaic on the early arch of the apse shows Christ's blessing surrounded by saints and martyrs. This is the canopy, a shrine with four small columns enclosing the high altar built in 1148. The choir of the basilica has its original pavement of white marble, porphyry, and serpentine. This is the chapel of Pope Pius IX, where the longest reigning pope in history, as well as the pope who convened the first Vatican Council and decreed the dogma of the Immaculate Conception of Mary, is interred. Pilgrimage to this basilica helps us to reflect on the fact that following Christ is not a sad journey full of suffering, but the discovery of real joy and true freedom despite the situation. Saint Lawrence, Saint Stephen, Saint Justin, and the hundreds of martyrs have shown us the way.